Welcome to TechBytes. My name is Tom Fastner with Teradata Labs, and I want to give you a quick overview of column-based table design options that are available in Teradata 15.10.
Building upon the first part of the row and column partition tables, where we reviewed the hash-based data distribution and looked at row-based table options, we will now focus on the physical data model options using columnar tables. The original implementation of the columnar tables back in Teradata 14.0 was predicated on a NoPI table, a table without a primary index. In 15.10, we have added the capability to have a column partition table with a primary index, and we also added a new concept called primary AMP that allows you to pick a column used for data distribution. The optimizer is aware of that, but the row hash is not stored with the data. Column partition tables have been designed for space use and I/O reduction. This in turn can give you better performance due to column partition elimination and compression. Depending on the choice of column partition tables, you can get similar efficiencies as with row-based tables in regards to single AMP access, AMP local aggregations, and co-location for joins. An important point to note is that this particular feature is a physical design choice, just like any other design choice you have, like primary index, row-based tables, column-based tables, indexes, join indexes, non-unique secondary indexes, and your performance will vary by use case. As mentioned before, you will experience performance gains when selecting small subsets of rows and/or columns, benefiting from a more granular partition elimination. First, we'll step through a columnar table with no primary index. As you can see, we are using the same artist album example we used in the row-based table recording. But the picture has changed. There is no longer a physical row with columns in it. Instead, the logical rows span a set of column containers. There is one container for each column, and the individual containers house a specific set of data. When you are creating the columnar tables, the physical implementation of that has to be handled for you by the database, but it's no longer in traditional row and column form, it's in column partition form. Since the initial implementation, the columnar tables were predicated on a NoPI table. There is no row hash used at any time. Rows are distributed across EMs in round-robin fashion in the same manner as it is for the row-based table with no primary index. Since there is no row hash in the NoPI tables, there is no sorting for row hash as data is stored on the AMP. What does this mean from the consideration point of view? A columnar NoPI table eliminates queue the same way as a row-based NoPI table does. Data is distributed in a round-robin fashion across all AMPs, so a non-optimal PI or the unintended default of the first column being the PI do not manifest in potentially massive data skew. There is no sorting of the rows at the end of the loading operation, so you can get an overall performance gain when loading the NoPI tables. On the other hand, it does not allow for single AMP access of rows nor provide co-located joins for the same reason as it does for row-based NoPI tables. However, column partitioning can be used to achieve query performance via column partition elimination. Let me give you an example. Let's say we have a table with 2,000 columns and you're just interested in two of those columns. If this table is row-based, you would have to physically read all full rows with all 2,000 columns just to pick out the two columns you're looking for. So it's basically a full table scan. In a column partition table, you would only have to read those two column partitions that have the columns you're interested in. The other 1,998 column partitions remain untouched. So the I/O would be just a fraction of the full table scan, resulting in much less I/O and runtime. Here's a DDL definition of the columnar table with no primary index. Note the designation used to partition by column with no primary index. The next option is a columnar table with a primary index. Columnar table with a primary index. Row hash is generated by system at load time and stored with each row. It's used to determine which AMP the data belongs to and is stored in row hash sequence. So what does it mean from a considerations point of view? The columnar PI option gives you single AMP access when accessing one single row out of the table, specifying the primary index columns. And you get efficient aggregation when using group by on the index columns. And it also does provide for collocation of joins, turning them into AMP local operations. Because a table is column partitioned, you get performance gains in queries through column partition elimination, yielding a reduction in I/O. So you get all the benefits of the PI table on top of benefits of column partition tables. Here's a DDL definition of a columnar table with a primary index designation. We chose again artist as the primary index and partitioned the table by column. Finally, we're going to get into a new concept associated with columnar tables in Teradata Database 1510 called primary AMP. The idea is based on some early lessons learned through working with NoPI tables. I mentioned that NoPI tables avoid having skewed data. This is true in most cases, but there is an exception when you carry forward existing data skew into a NoPI table. In other words, when you do an insert select from an already skewed table into a NoPI table, the data will be copied locally on the AMP for efficiency reasons. So, this new table will be as skewed as the source table. To help with this, we introduced the hash by clause that will force a redistribution of the data based on the hash by columns or the keyword random. However, this information is not kept for further use, so the optimizer does not remember that the data is physically distributed in a way that allows for collocation, AMP local aggregation, or single AMP access. The CP-PA table follows the same idea. You can specify a set of columns to serve as input to the data distribution, but this information is not sorted with the data itself, and therefore the data can't be sorted by it either. However, it is kept with the table definition, and therefore the optimizer is aware of how the data is distributed and can optimize for certain scenarios. And what does it mean to you? The CP-PA table will not automatically address skew, since you have to define the PA columns, as you do with PI columns, but there is no need to sort the data on the AMP, resulting in an overall performance gain during the load process. Columnar tables with primary AMP do allow single AMP access. The primary AMP designation allows the optimizer to find the AMP that holds the data based on the PA column values given. But since the data is not stored on the AMP, it will have to scan all rows on that AMP in order to locate the data. Since it is still a column partition table, performance gains through column partition elimination is still possible. Finally, for a columnar table with primary AMP designation, even though you didn't save the row hash along with each row, the optimizer is aware of the hashing column and can use it for collocated joins. So, if you want to play with columnar tables, CP-PA should be your first choice. With good partitioning, it can get close to the same performance of a CP-PI structure, avoiding the overhead associated with storing and sorting the hash. Here's a DDL definition for a columnar table with primary AMP. You see the primary AMP keyword. In this example, we chose the artist column for hashing the data, but the hash is not saved with each row, and we are partitioning it by the column. Finally, here's a summary of all characteristics and considerations we have gone through for both row-based tables and column partition tables. You can use this as a reference to pick and choose what values you most desire in your physical database design.